and the world. They will be here and they will discuss the topic, which is about creating brands. So let's begin. So when I say conversations, it is a two-way process. We talk to each other. So as I said, I respect the people who sit, who are occupying the back tables. They are the smartest. So any volunteers who would like to talk to me? Any volunteers? Ladies? If there are no volunteers, I'll have to pick somebody. Am I allowed to do so? Any volunteers? No? Any volunteers? No volunteers. Okay, sir. Mr. Abhay Mehta, we met yesterday. So can you please get up? Okay. Now, are you a brand?
Yes.
Is Mehta Jewelers a brand?
Yes.
Give him a big hand. Sir, Abhay says he's a brand. Is the statement true or false?
I just met yesterday.
Yeah.
Maybe he's right.
Maybe. Either yes or no.
Yes.
Thank you. So the point which I'm trying to make is anything can be a brand. A brand can be a product, it can be a service, it can be a person. Gaurav Gupta is a brand. He's a designer. Sachin Jain himself is a brand. Sir, what's your good name?
Akash Sagar Gupta.
And what do you do?
I'm a jeweler.
You are a jeweler? You are a brand? Or your company is a brand? What is the name of your firm?
Narayan Prabhu Jewelers.
Okay. So, if I'm right, your firm, under the name of which you do business, is a monetized brand, but you as a person is not a monetized brand. Am I right?
Right.
Okay, great. Now, talking to the ladies, madam, which is your favorite brand? Any product category?
Maybe Vero Moda.
Vero Moda. Why do you like the brand? Dressing style, okay. Anybody else would like to take a crack, madam? Which is your favorite brand?
Well, for me, like, it's different, different brands which I like, but what I like is which can help increase and improve my life.
Okay. So, are you aware which is the number one soap in India? Number one, highest selling soap in India. Any guesses?
Yes.
Beg your pardon?
Peers.
Okay. Anybody else like to take a try? Lux. Somebody said Lux. Have you heard of Lifebuoy? So among the top three brands in India, three are from Hindustan Lever. And number one brand is Lifebuoy. Number two brand used to be Lux. But last year, which brand has overtaken Lux? Can you guess? It's Santoor. So why Santoor has taken over? Santoor has taken over because people have bought the story. Meri twacha se meri umr ka pata hi nahi chalta. Have you seen this ad? Okay. Anybody who has not seen the ad? Hey, audience thodi thandi hai. No matter what question they are, you ask, they never raise hands. I don't blame you guys because raising hands means, you know, getting out of the comfort zone, relaxing or exercising your muscles. But when it comes to flexing your muscles, everybody is ready. If I provoke you, you will say, "Abet teritto." Then there is no problem. But if I ask you to do something, you will not do unless it is of interest to you. So the point which I want to make is, every brand has a story. Okay. Now, there are two types of ads. Ads which tell a story, and ads which do not tell a story. Yesterday, there were two ads in Bombay Times, jewelry ads. One is 90% of the jewelry ads are like this. They show a picture of a lady, they show a visual of the jewelry, and they say 50% off. And there is this brand, this ad from For Your Mark, it tries to sell a story. Now, let me give you an example. In the Tower of London, there is an exhibition where crown jewels are displayed. There are 2,888 diamonds. And there are biggest diamonds in the world, like Cullinan 1 and Cullinan 2. But guess what? Which brand is the most, gets the highest recall? Any guesses? It's the Kohinoor. So India is the country which has not given, not just given the world the first diamond, but it has given the first diamond brand, which is Kohinoor, eternal brand. So we all know the value of a brand, but we have lost the way somewhere. Okay. Now, when you talk about a jewelry brand, any guesses? Which is the popular brand? Which is the highest selling brand? Tanishq? Yes. Now, I'll just give you an example. What did Tanishq do? Have you heard of neuroscience? Neuroscience is now used in market research. There is an apparatus called transcranial magnetic resonator. I have not heard about this till last week. It is like an oversized helmet. And what Tata Group did was, they did a survey of 1,400 people. They made them wear this helmet. And there were those responses. They were given electrical impulses, and their response was recorded on electroencephalogram. And eye movements were studied. So there are the findings of the study I'll just share with you. They were shown the TV commercials, but this process can be used for visual merchandising, packaging, for advertising, anything it can be used. The result findings are like this. TV commercial with a storytelling approach have 20% greater chance of consumer forming long-term associations. Storytelling has higher emotional connect. Consumers believe in TV commercials that have a storytelling approach versus those which do not have a storytelling approach. Now, when we do market research, what the agencies tell you? The agencies tell you the brand recall is very important. But this study says that person can recall a good TV commercial as well as a bad commercial. But it does not mean that they will buy the brand which does not have a story. So with these words, I would now like to invite Amit Challu on stage. Amit. So I'm sure everybody must have heard of the name LVMH, Louis Vuitton. Amit was with Louis Vuitton, now he's a consultant, he's advising brands in India as well as international brands. He has worked in LVMH for 12 years, and he has worked not only in India, but in China as well as Japan. So he's going to share with us the power of storytelling and how a brand remains relevant despite this heritage extending to more than 100 years. Over to you, Amit. Please give him a big hand.
Hello. Yeah. So thank you very much for the introduction, Anil Jay. And I won't claim that I know all branding. We are all learning, as long as we live, we continue to learn, and new brands come up, some brands go away. So creating new brands, this is a topic, and everybody wants, now everybody is, very interesting to know how brands are created, how LVMH has created almost 86 brands. And in luxury space, they almost have a very predominant, positioning in luxury brands. So creating brand basically involves bringing together a lot of elements. What are those elements? It's like good product, great product, great design, good, I would say, innovative store concept, CRM, good, customer service, and also, continuity of what you're doing. Okay, so this all comes to create a brand. As Anil mentioned, that storytelling is a very important aspect of creating brands. So today, I'm gonna focus a little bit on storytelling. I've chosen two brands. One is Tag Heuer, a Swiss watchmaking company. Another is Bulgari. It's a high-end jewelry company, Italian company, well-known company. And I'm gonna tell you, how do they tell their story? Why we are talking about a watchmaking company? Because yesterday there was a discussion and we talked about, you know, we should aspire to be like Swiss watch manufacturing companies. Switzerland is almost exporting 18 billion US dollar watches across the world. Can we do the same thing in jewelry sector in India? But I also want to tell you that even Swiss watchmaking is struggling today, despite they having a very strong branding. They have a history, heritage, for which is longer than 150 years. So if you have been in business for 150 years, and you have a very strong story, history, but you still don't connect with the new customers, the younger customers, you end up losing customers. Your business couldn't disappear. Tomorrow you were a very big brand. Oh, yesterday you were a very big brand. Tomorrow you could not be there. So this has happened. You know, if you look at leading brands who were very strong in yesteryears are no longer there. So I want to play a video of Tag Heuer, which wants to be a disruptive brand, provocative brand, doesn't want to follow any laid down guidelines, rules, and this is what you do when you're young. And this is how they want to connect with young generations. Can you play the Tag Heuer video, please?
In theory, you run with your legs. In theory, you play the guitar with your fingers. In theory, graffiti is vandalism. And madness is a weakness. In theory, walls are climbed over. In theory, boats don't fly. In theory, molecules are for chemists. In theory, stunts are done by doubles. In theory, you can't impact science before graduation. In theory, you can't score in every match. In theory, you crack under pressure.
So, what is the storytelling here? This brand is 150 years old brand. It's a leading brand. I would say number four watchmaking, Swiss watchmaking brand in the world. And they are saying, we are not going to rest on our past. We are going to change the rules of the game. We are going to disrupt the whole industry. And this is how you, I mean, this is how they want to connect with youth. Today in jewelry sector, a lot of discussion is going down. How do we connect to the younger generation? How do we connect to the young customer? So if you want to connect to a young customer, you have to think like a young guy. A guy who's 22 years old. He doesn't like what has happened in the past. You start telling him a story of 150 years old story of your brand history. He doesn't have that kind of patience, energy to listen to that story. So this is how Tag Heuer is trying to connect with younger audience. This is their style to tell story. So there is no right and wrong style to tell story. Everybody has their own style to tell story. The second video I want to show you is of a brand called Bulgari. So I think most of you know Bulgari is among the most prominent brands in the world. Especially by far they are number one brand in Italy. And they're going to tell their story. But the way they tell their story is very different from Tag Heuer. And there's no right and wrong way to tell a story. Everybody has a style. So we had a speaker who had his own style, was very funny, very interactive. That was a style. Then we have Anil G. He has his own style. So similarly, brands are like people. They have their own style. They have their own personality. They talk to their customer differently. So we'll see how does Bulgari talk to its customer. And then there was an interesting discussion yesterday, and we were talking how we should learn from China, right, as an industry. How we should get inspired by European brands, especially Italian brands. Create products, jewelry, which is contemporary, which can be used daily, and on and on. So now in this video, you would see what inspires Bulgari. You know, can I ask you, Anyone knows Bulgari? Do people know Bulgari? How many people know Bulgari? Okay. Do you know what is their major inspiration? Sorry? Absolutely right. One of the inspiration of Bulgari is colors, you know, in jewelry. Anything else? What could inspire one of the most successful jewelry brands in the world? You have no idea.
India.
Absolutely right. Okay? So this is what we need to learn. And what is the inspiration? Do we know how in India, what is the inspiration in India? How could you get inspired in India? Next step. India, yeah. India is a very big name. There are a lot of things in India.